co-host and affiliates, my name is Christina, and welcome to another Let's Get Reels movie review. Today's movie I will be reviewing for you is Alien from 1979. I had never seen Alien before. I recently watched it, and I really liked it. I'm not really into sci-fi movies, but I just had the need, the desire to watch Alien. It's such an iconic movie. My brothers really, really like it, and I'm like, you know what? It's time I sit my ass down and I watch Alien, and I did. It's always been a movie I've seen clips of, or I've just heard about. Mel Brooks famously made fun of the alien popping out of the guy's stomach in Spaceballs, and now it was great to finally, like, really, really see the context and what it was, you know, what Mel Brooks was referencing, and actually see the whole context of that scene, because I think everybody has seen that scene where the alien pops out of the guy's stomach, but it's like, do you know the rest of the story? And the rest of the story is just like, to me, it's just no one listening to the woman who is left in charge. Not to get like all feminist and like, you know, get crazy about, oh, females, yes, badass females. I don't want to do that, but you know, this movie, it's true. You know, nobody listened to the woman. Nobody listened to the main character of Ellen Ripley when she said, I'm not letting you in, because these guys went out on like an alien planet. It takes place in the future, and they're like a cargo ship, and they get like an SOS call. They're like, we have to do it, there's something in distress. So they go check out this, what turns out to be like an alien spaceship, and the one guy gets this alien attached to his face. It's so freaking gross. It's like my worst nightmare. And she's like, I can't let you in. I have to quarantine you guys for 24 hours. I am in charge when nobody else is on this ship. And the ship's captain and the second in command were all with that exploration group, that and the guy that got the freaking thing on his face. And she's like, I can't let you in. You gotta stay outside, quarantine for 24 hours. That is the regulation. That is the law. You're gonna be breaking the law. And they're like, let us in. This guy's gonna die. So this scientist that's on board is like, all right, I'm letting them in. And you find out why. There's other ulterior motives for this stopping at this spaceship, this other spaceship, and then the scientist opening the door. But I'm like, you dumbasses, you should have listened to Ripley. What are you doing? And of course, because nobody listened to her, they all eat shit. Besides Ripley, because she is a badass, kick-ass bitch who takes over and just knows what to do. She keeps her head up, she keeps herself calm, and she gets this alien and kicks its ass. I just, like, you know, I'm sitting there, I turn to my brother and that part, I'm like, man, are they gonna wish they listened to Ripley? I'm like, why didn't anybody listen to Ripley? Why didn't nobody listen to the woman? And they were like, the guys are putting her down and all that stuff. I'm like, you in about 10 minutes are gonna wish that you had listened to a woman, you had listened to Ripley. But you know, of course it wouldn't be a movie if people listened to other people who listened to the voice of reason in these movies. There wouldn't have been an Alien. There wouldn't have been a movie. So yes, I completely understand that they couldn't listen to Ripley. They had to move the plot along and not listen and open the door and let this alien in on their ship. I get it. I totally get it. No complaining in the comments about that. I'm really, really happy that I sat down to watch Alien. I really liked it, and I'm kind of upset that it took me so long, but at the same time, I think I appreciate it a lot more that I watched it when I'm older and when I'm more of like a movie fan, because I get a lot of the reference. Apparently the director took some inspiration from Star Wars, which you can clearly see in some frames of the movie, some shots. If you're very familiar with Star Wars, be like, that looks like a Star Wars shot from the film. That's exactly what I said. I like turned to my brother and I'm like, that's Star Wars. But it's not like, you know, horribly done. It's like perfect. And it just shows you the magnitude of the ship, it shows you, like, you know, what's going on, just like in Star Wars. And I give the director credit. I think who's in Ridley Scott, Tony Scott, one of the Scots, and he was great. I really liked the direction. I liked how in some scenes there wasn't a lot of talking. It really built the tension. I am for not too much talking in intense scenes. I really like that build up because I feel like you get more nervous when people don't talk. Like, think about if it's silent or if you're walking with someone and it's silent and you're like, okay, I feel this need to talk, I feel this need. There's no need for it, you know? You feel like tension when there's no talking, but there is no need for it. And I think in a movie, like, the non-talking just builds up so much tension, and it was great. It builds up like, oh my god, these people are gonna get eaten, and like, you know, you just feel it. You know something bad is gonna happen when they just stop talking, and you just see how scared they and horrified they are to run into this alien and meet their demise. I liked all the actors in this movie. Sigourney Weaver is just awesome. I mean, for me, she'll just always be Dana Barrett from the Ghostbusters, but I like seeing her in something else, and especially like one of her earlier movies. She was great. She was like the quiet hero for me. She wasn't like, you know, Laura Croft or anything, and she didn't really have a lot to say. There was no like super toughness in her voice. There was no like really swagger in the way she walked. You know, she's much different to what we would think of like tough female characters or strong female characters. She just did what she had to do to survive. And she probably was never made to do all she did in this movie or trained to do all she did in this movie. And I thought that was great, you know, seeing something a little bit different than what we're used to seeing with tough girls. You know, we're used to seeing, like, you know, Supergirl or Elektra from the Daredevil series, or like Jessica Jones, or Sydney Bristow from Alias, or whatever have you. And she was just something a little different. She was like what I call a quiet toughness that wasn't like, you know, or a will to survive toughness, and I like that. I found it to be different, and I enjoyed that very much. You have Tom Skerritt before he went gray and was kind of like a parody of himself. He played Dallas, who I believe is the ship's captain. You have Ian Holm, who was Ash, and he famously plays Bilbo Baggins in the Lord of the Rings movies. And then you have John Hurt. I don't know if I've ever seen John Hurt like younger. I've always seen him like in his most recent movies where he's an older man, and usually he's like a little bit of a weirdo. Like, I know him mostly from Indiana Jones and the Kingdom of the Crystal Skull. Unfortunately, I know. I'm sorry. Forgive me for that. The rest of the cast was pretty cool. I'm really not familiar with their works. I think I've seen the other actress in the movie. Her name escapes me, and I'm gonna hate myself after I do this and I look up her name, because she was a little girl in The Birds, and I just can't think of her name. She was good. She really didn't have that much to do, and of course she's the one that one of the people that, you know, get gobbled up by the alien. So that was my review/rambling of Alien. If you liked this review in any way, please give it a thumbs up. Leave your comments down below if you have seen Alien. Let's talk about anything you want. Sets, direction, actors, anything you want with this movie. I would love to hear your input, your insight. I'm sure some of you are probably bigger fans than I am of Alien, and maybe you've seen it more than I have, so let's just discuss. I would love to have conversations with you guys. And also in the comments, if you have any movie suggestions, doesn't matter what they are, what type of movies, leave them there, and if I pick your movie and I watch it and I review it, I will give you a shout out. And don't forget to hit that subscribe button for future Let's Get Reels movie reviews, because that is what I like to do here. And as always, keep watching movies and stay absolutely fabulous.